Hey there, everybody. Today we are going to break down how one of the most important parts of the body that's involved in childbirth works, and that is the cervix. So I know you're not here for some kind of boring medical diagram. Nope. Today we are bringing you a different kind of explanation. Actually, we're going to use an analogy. I'm going to show a short animation, and we're going to look at a 3D kind of a stop motion video all together to get an idea of how the cervix works in labor. Now, since my background is in engineering and computer programming, I even threw in a little code example of how contractions work. Now, make sure you stay till the end of the video so you can let me know which of these explanations you liked best. Now, let's jump into that analogy. So I like to think of the cervix as a door. The cervix is located at the bottom of the uterus, and inside the uterus is where the baby lives. And so the cervix at the bottom of the uterus acts like a door, and when we are in labor, it acts like an exit. But it's not just a regular kind of door. I like to think of it as a door with this kind of lock here. Now, you'll notice on this lock that there are four separate dials. I like the four dials because the cervix actually has to change in four different ways before the exit totally opens, before that door opens, and the baby can pass through out of the uterus. So the four different ways that the cervix will change, a couple of them you might find that you already know, a couple of them you might not. So you probably heard of dilation. Dilation is the opening of the cervix, and it opens from 0 centimeters to 10 centimeters. And then we have effacement, which is where the cervix starts out thick and thins, and it is measured in percentages. So we've got 0% when it's nice and thick, and then 100% when it's nice and thin. Then the other two that you might not have heard of, one is a position. So the position of the cervix, it starts off being pointed towards our back when we're pregnant. That's anterior. And then as our cervix changes, it moves and ends up posterior. Finally, the consistency, or what the cervix feels like, it does change as that lock opens. And it goes from hard, which might feel kind of like your forehead, if you touch that there, and then it softens kind of like your nose. And then it's nice and soft, kind of like your lips. Did you do that? You probably did that with me, right? So dilation, or the opening of the cervix, is the one that we usually talk about the most. I have this fun little animation that I want to show you that shows how dilation can look. Now, you'll notice that it starts off closed, and then as it finishes up, it is 10 centimeters dilated. Now, notice in the animation that the cervix doesn't always open smoothly. So it seems to open slowly, and then sometimes it makes bigger jumps. Now, we witness this behavior in labor as well. It's common to slowly progress through the first 6 centimeters of labor, and then sometimes jump to, say, 8 centimeters or 10 centimeters even quicker. And that's in that active and transition phase of labor. Hey, if you like that animation, make sure you hit the like button so I can show Nathan, my son, what a good job he did. Okay, so that was dilation. Let's add a visual that's really going to demonstrate that thinning of the cervix, or the effacement. And for this, we're going to look at some stop motion Play-Doh videos. So you'll see in this video that the cervix starts off closed and thick. And then after contraction happens, we start seeing the cervix thin and it's opening. Notice how it goes from thick to starting to be thinner, 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 and then eventually at the end we have a paper thin cervix. Now, I love this video because this quantity of Play-Doh that's used for the closed cervix is the one that we use to make the open cervix. So it's really clear that a cervix in that shape, closed and thick, can thin and dilate and efface. Now, all of this change to the cervix, those four different locks to our door, they all change as a result of contractions. And it's really just contractions that happen over and over and over and over and over again. So my programming mind from way back in my pre-childbirth educator days wanted to create a little bit of code just to describe how contractions work and how they affect the cervix. So take a look at this example that I wrote in sort of a JavaScript of how the cervix would work. And now let's take a peek at a Python example. What do you guys think? You programmers out there that are watching, let me know in the comments below if I got that right or how you would change it. Okay, guys, we talked all about the cervix, but there are some other interesting parts of anatomy and things that happen in labor that I'm sure you'll want to find out before birth happens. So I put a link here to a playlist that you're going to want to check out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.